a lot of talk in agriculture about humic and fulvic acids. They're organic acids that are naturally out there in your fields. But what if we're using those products in different ways? Could we get more gain from our crop? We're going to discuss this today.
Okay, so I even put together a little list here of some of the things that people will talk about with humic and fulvic acids and some of the benefits that get described. So just real quick, reduce water and nutrient loss in low CEC soils, improve aeration and tilth in tight heavy soils, increase soil aggregation, increase soil water holding capacity, make the soil a little darker color, which increases sunlight absorption. You can regulate pH value of soils, improve nutrient and water uptake, increase the buffering properties of soil. There are a whole bunch of benefits, or at least potential benefits, that could come out of humic and fulvic acid. So when you hear this, you probably go, well, this sounds like the greatest stuff in the history of the world. I got to use this on every acre. Well, it may or may not fit in your operation. So what we really want to focus on here is, where are we seeing gains and where have we not necessarily seen as much?
All right, let's start with planting time. And when you think about the planter, there's a lot more going on than just dropping seed in the ground. Often there are natural or biological products like bacteria and beneficial fungi being applied. And there's also fertility going out. Now, when you think about soil applied fertility, activating the biology around that fertility to help bring it into the plant in a usable form is really important. Humic acid is one of those substances that has been used for many years in this capacity. Putting it right with those in-furrow applications gives you an opportunity to have it in a concentrated spot where it can do the most benefit for you for the least amount of cost.
Now, let me say this. When we talk about humic acid, inside that is fulvic acid. Fulvic acid is a smaller molecule, but typically when you're getting humic, you're getting humic plus fulvic. When you're getting fulvic acid, you are just getting fulvic, so the smaller molecule, not the bigger molecule. With that small molecule of fulvic, that can typically penetrate cells better, that can help bring nutrients in a little bit better. So a lot of times we'll talk to high yield farmers and they say, make sure that you put fulvic acid together with your foliar nutrients, and that's something we've started doing ourselves and seen a little bit better response that way. So when Darren says throw humic out there, you absolutely can. But humic is more of a soil conditioner, and if we separate out the portion that's just the fulvic, that's usually the component where we say, all right, we're going to put that together with fertilizer to help get more things into the plant, either foliar or in furrow.
You may be wondering, are your soils going to be improved by using something like humic acid? And it is a little bit of a hit and miss thing, where in some areas, if soils are just perfect and everything's great and the soil health is fantastic and soil pH is ideal, nutrient content is high, you may not see as much gain out of humic acid. For example, if you've got already 3 or 4 or 5% organic matter out there in a very healthy, well-balanced soil, it may not provide you a huge gain. However, maybe you have some heavy soils, but there are a lot of challenges. We especially see this in the north. When we look at poorly drained, heavy soils, they're cold, and soil health in general is not quite as good. We're seeing some big benefits in many cases from using a humic acid application at planting time.
So what Darren's talking about is our specific research on this in multi-states, and where we have seen the better response is the more challenging soils. But again, like what Darren said, if your soil is absolutely perfect, your organic matter's 5, you've got your phosphorus built up, your potassium built up, your pH is absolutely right, you're already getting 250, 280 bushel corn, chances are you're not going to see the same kind of return. I'm not saying you shouldn't use the product, but where we've seen the very best gains out of humic acid is on the tough soils.
Well, one of the challenges here though too, Brian, for farmers trying to pick out the right humic acid product, is there really isn't a standardized way for humics to be measured. Oftentimes it's based on color. Well, it's a little darker, so it must be a little more humic or something like that, and that's really tough. I love chemistry where we know, all right, there's this percentage of glyphosate in the tank and we know exactly what we're getting. When it's a humic acid product, there isn't that scale to measure things by. So you do have to do a little bit of research as to which products are working, which ones are showing a better benefit.
Yep, I agree with that 100%. So our whole point here is don't get sucked in by snake oil. There are going to be some people selling very inferior humic acid products fulvic acid products. And because there's no standard in the industry, because there's nothing you can exactly look at on the label, it's going to be tough to sort that out. So I wish we could just tell you, yep, buy this product or do this thing or look for this particular ingredient. It's just unfortunately not super simple with humic acid and fulvic acid. So again, we just want to leave you with this. Humic and fulvics definitely can have some benefits. We look at humic as more of a soil conditioner. We look at the fulvic portion of humic, if you can buy that separately, to go together with fertilizer, either in furrow or foliar, and we are seeing some gains in all these cases, but we're seeing more gains where we have tougher soil conditions to deal with.
Well, one thing that can be a problem for you, whether your soils are tougher or better, is weed pressure, and our weed of the week is certainly a tough one to control. We'll show you how to stop it later in the show.